Welcome students on our next lecture on aromatic electrophilic substitution reaction. In previous lecture we had seen about the nitration reaction and also the general features of electrophilic substitution reactions, how they occur and what is the energy profile diagram that we had seen it in our last lecture. Now in this lecture we will be concentrating more on a sulfonation reaction. To recap, we had seen that there are four major types of chemical reactions. One is an addition reaction, where two reactants X plus Y gives rise to products. And in the second type, where elimination reactions, where one of the products will be giving rise to, one of the reactants will be splitted in such a way that there are two different products will be formed. Like for example, here we can say it of a, say, CH3 CH2 CH2 Br. This can eliminate one hydrogen and one bromine to give us a CH3 CH double bond CH plus an HBr molecule will be eliminated out of the reacting molecule. So such reactions we call it as a elimination reactions, which generally occurs via formation of a multiple bonds. In addition reaction, we can have it like the CH3 CH double bond CH2 plus HBr will be giving rise to CH3 CH2, or we can have a CH2 CH2 Br. Depending on the conditions, we can have this product, plus we can have another product where bromine can get attached to a middle carbon. We will have two bromopropane or one bromopropane, we can have it. What is important feature here is that multiple bond, multiple carbon-carbon bond has been reduced to a carbon-carbon single bond. So in addition reaction, it is a reduction of the number of bonds the carbon atoms. In an elimination reaction, the double bonds increases. From a single bond, it can be a double bond, or from a double bond, a triple bond can be formed. In a redox reaction, it is generally the exchange of electrons are happening. Exchange of electrons happens in a redox reaction. Like for example, a CH3CH2OH gets oxidized to CH3CHO. That is from a ethanol and acetaldehyde, and from acetaldehyde we can get a acetic acid. So these reactions are all redox reactions, where these molecules are getting oxidized, and the species which is getting acting upon this as a catalyst will be getting reduced. Fourth one is a substitution reaction, in which there is an exchange of group of atoms is happening. Like for example, we have a CH3 CH CH3. Here, if it is an X is there, we can react it with some Y minus, or we can react it with Y such that CH3, CH, CH3, and here we can get a Y. So this type of reactions where an exchange is happening, that we call it as a substitution reaction. Here, X is getting substituted by Y. So in this such reactions, we have a substitution reaction. Our topic of interest for today is a substitution reaction. Substitution reactions involve substitution of one atom or a group of atoms by another atom or a group of atoms. Depending on the charge of the incoming group, that is, in the previous case, what we had, it was Y was replacing the X atom. In our previous example, this Y is replacing X. So depending on the charge on the Y, we can have classify the substitution reactions into two types, one as an electrophilic substitution reaction and a nucleophilic substitution reaction. In electrophilic substitution reaction, Y, the incoming group, will be having, will be an electron deficient species. So it will be having either a positive charge or it will be a slightly positive charge. It will have either full positive charge or it will be a slightly positive charge, so that it will be deficient of electrons and will have an empty orbital where the electrons can be accommodated. So if the incoming group is an electron deficient with a slight positive charge or a full positive charge, then such substitution reactions, we call it as the electrophilic substitution reaction. The second is a nucleophilic substitution reaction, where the incoming group Y is electron-rich species. It has either a complete negative charge or it has a lone pair of electrons. The electrophile must have a positive charge, or it should have a delta positive charge, or it should have an empty orbital where the electrons can be accommodated, extra electrons can be accommodated. A nucleophile, or in a nucleophilic substitution, the nucleophile Y must have a negative charge, or it should have a lone pair of electrons which are donatable. A donatable lone pair of electrons is must for a nucleophilic substitution reaction. So this way we can classify the substitution reactions into two: electrophilic substitution reactions and a nucleophilic substitution reactions. Today we will be concentrating on electrophilic substitution reactions. In previous lecture we had seen about the nitration of aromatic groups, that is nitration of benzene, we had seen it. Now whenever we are looking after the aromatic groups, we can say that they are forming, like for example we have a benzene ring. This benzene ring, each carbon atom is having one double bond is present on each of the carbon atoms, means all the carbon atoms are sp2 hybridized. They are all having sp2 hybridization, where sp2 hybridization means one s orbital and two p orbitals are getting hybridized to form three sp2 hybridized orbitals, that is one from s and two from p, total three orbitals mixed together to form three sp2 hybridized orbitals. Still we have one p orbital which is not participating in this hybridization process, so it will remain as such while the other three will be getting hybridized. So what we will have a shape of that is like three sp2 hybrid orbitals are there. This blue colored orbitals are three sp2 hybridized orbitals, we will get it, which are 120 degrees apart from each other, and they are in one single plane. They are in the xz plane, in one single plane they are there. And one orbital which is not hybridized, which is not participating in the hybridization process, will be perpendicular to the plane of this three hybridized orbitals. So this will be, let's say it is on the y-axis, then these three orbitals will be along the xz plane. So this unhybridized p orbital will participate in the formation of double bond, or in the formation of a pi bond. Aromatic compounds are electron rich due to resonance of pi electrons. We know that whenever an aromatic group is being formed, there are double bonds are being formed. We have three double bonds in a benzene ring. Now when there is a double bond is there, there will be an overlap between the orbitals. This overlap between the orbitals leads to resonance energies, where this particular orbital overlaps with this orbital, as well as it overlaps with the other orbital also in the next instance. So that the electrons are free to move around on the all the six orbitals of the six carbon atoms. Six p orbitals are there on each, one on each of the carbon atoms of benzene ring, so that these six orbitals are forming three pi bonds, and they are exchanging amongst themselves due to resonance structures. Like this benzene ring has a resonance structure of this kind, so that each of the orbital is getting exchanged, exchanging its partner. So it is a dance where the partners are being getting exchanged regularly. So we will have a different type of we will have this pi electrons are being all circulating among the six orbitals. So there will be a cloud of pi electrons above the plane of this six carbon, and also below the plane of six carbon. So we will have a pi electron cloud over the benzene and also below the benzene. So the benzene ring will be flanked between the pi electron or pi clouds. So because of this pi clouds, this benzene ring becomes electron rich species, and it can act as a nucleophile. as it is an electron rich species, so it can act as a nucleophile. It can attack on any of the any of the species which are electrophile or which are electron deficient species. Hence, these aromatic compounds can attack on an electron deficient species and bring about the electrophilic substitution reactions. The pi electrons of aromatic compound attacks the electrophile to form an adduct stabilized through the resonance. This we had seen it in our nitration also, and we will see it in the sulfonation also. In sulfonation, the overall reaction is that sulfonation of benzene involves the benzene with a reaction with H2SO4, that is concentrated sulfuric acid. At 40 degrees Celsius, it gives us benzene sulfonic acid. And we get water as the byproduct. Similarly, instead of concentrated H2SO4, we can also take SO3, that is sulfur trioxide, at 25 degrees Celsius in presence of oleum. Oleum forms this sulfur trioxide. Oleum is nothing but 98% concentrated H2SO4. 98% concentrated H2SO4 is called as oleum. And this gives us benzene sulfonic acid, SO3H. So this is overall a reaction of sulfonation of benzene. But the first step for this will always be a generation of an electrophile, because it is an electrophilic substitution reaction. So we need an electrophile as the first step. So in our first step, there will be generation of an electrophile. That electrophile, if we are using concentrated H2SO4, then that concentrated H2SO4 will be in equilibrium reaction such that it forms a hydronium ion plus a sulfur trioxide and HSO4 minus. So this is equilibrium of the concentrated H2SO4, where a small amount of sulfur trioxide is formed. This sulfur trioxide acts as an electrophile, as it is flanked by three oxygen atoms, oxygen being more electronegative than sulfur. So sulfur attains a slightly positive charge, and hence it is having empty orbitals also. D orbitals are empty, so it can take up the extra electrons and participate in a reaction as an electrophile. So here, in this way, we can generate a electrophile if we are using a concentrated H2SO4. If we are using an oleum, then in oleum we get the sulfur trioxide as such direct. So sulfur trioxide will be acting as an electrophile in the sulfonation reaction. Second step for this is attack on the electrophile. We have the electrophile as an sulfur trioxide, and if a benzene ring is brought near to this sulfur trioxide, then that benzene ring, being an electron rich species, it will attack the empty orbitals of the sulfur and form an adduct, which is a slow process it will form an adduct where a proton is still part of this, and we will have a benzenonium ion . This benzenonium ion, here it will be a positive charge. So this benzenonium ion is stabilized through resonance, where this double bond will be moving towards this positive charge, and a positive charge will be come at this particular carbon atom. So we will have a positive charge here, a double bond, hydrogen and SO3 minus. Positive charge can further be stabilized through second cycle of resonance. Positive. So in this way, we can have an arenium ion or we can have a benzinonium ion. As it is a benzene that we are using it here, so it will be called as a benzinonium ion. If there is another aromatic group, the aromatic compound we are taking, then in general we can call it as an arenium ion. This arenium ion is stabilized through resonance. So it is a stable structure. Once it is formed, it can go back to benzene and sulfur trioxide, or it can move forward to form the products. So the next step or the last step will be the loss of proton or re-aromatization, where we will have a positive charge over here, a hydrogen, sulfur, a double bond and a double bond over here. This loses a proton to HSO4 minus, the counter ion that we had it, the conjugate base that we had, will extract the proton from here and it can pass the electrons into the benzene ring and we will get the aromatic character of the ring will be restored back. This can extract proton from H2SO4. Give us benzene sulfonic acid. This way we can form the benzene sulfonic acid or sulfonation step can be obtained. All the steps are reversible in this particular reaction. For sulfonation, all steps are reversible. Hence, the process is slow, but it can be fastened by using oleum at room temperature, that is at 25 degrees Celsius. If we are using oleum, then process becomes fast. And large amount of product is formed. So more amount of products or higher yields can be formed by when we are using oleum. If we are using concentrated H2SO4, then it will be a slow process and also less or low yields are formed. This was for sulfonation reactions. Thank you.